Hello students, welcome to Affairs Cloud. My name is Vikas. So friends, we have an application by the name Careers Cloud, which you can go and download through the Play Store. And once you have downloaded, you can log in with your Gmail ID. And why I'm suggesting you this application, because this is the one-stop solution for all the current affairs. This is the best of the best application and the platform where you can enhance your learning through help. Here you will be provided with multiple courses. Here you will be provided with multiple options of quizzes. And even you here you will be provided current affairs on daily basis. PDFs and quizzes will be provided to you on daily basis, both in Hindi as well as English. Here you will be provided current affairs with weekly basis and monthly basis also. Here remember, once you have done watching our video, then you can log in through this application, take out the PDF, read that PDF and go through the quizzes. That will enhance your preparation. Same you have to do for weekly and same you have to do for the monthly also. In monthly, you will be provided with the top 100 important questions PDF and video also that will enhance your learning, and it will be a very benefit and beneficial and important video for the revision perspective. And not just this, friends. Apart from this, we also provide you banking and economic questions. We provide you state current affairs such as of Uttarakhand, UP, Tripura, Telangana and many more. Not just this, apart from this, we also provide you topic wise current affairs, and the topics that we are providing you are really important. These topics are such as national affairs, international affairs, important days, sports, defense, science and technology, apps and web portals, obituary. These are the important topics that are being asked in various exams across India. So these are the topics that are must and should be covered and will be beneficial for the preparation of the students.
Hello everyone. So in this video, we will be discussing important current affairs of 26th of September. The session will be quite interesting, so do pay attention till the end. The first news that we are discussing is that India's first lighthouse festival was held recently. Question asked here is that in which state to promote lighthouses as a tourist destination, India's first ever lighthouse festival was held. So in which state did we observe this lighthouse festival? It was in Goa, right? And the sole reason for this was to promote lighthouses as a tourist destination. This was held in Goa from 23rd to 25th of September, right? And remember, this festival was inaugurated by whom? It was inaugurated by Sarbandana Sonowalji. Correct. Apart from this, where was this held? This was held at Fort Aguada. That is in Panjim, Goa. Right. And this festival was celebrated across all the lighthouses in India to promote the historic sport, that is the lighthouses as a tourist destination. Then this festival was to promote the Triple P partnership for transforming these lighthouses into world-class tourist destination, right? And the transformation of them will be done under the campaign that is Lighthouse Heritage Tourism. Apart from this, remember, Goa, they will provide IVF free of cost, that is free in vitro fertilization, and this will be in the government hospitals, right? Then in India has at least 203 lighthouses that are spread across 7,517 kilometers of coastline of India. Who is the governor of Goa? P.S. Sridharan Pillaiji, Chief Minister Pramod Sawant, and there are international airports such as your Manohar International Airport. Correct. So here you can see India's first lighthouse festival began in Goa. Then tell me which state topped in the fiscal health report, right? Fiscal health report was released and which state topped here? It is Maharashtra. Then Gramin Mitra scheme. This was launched by which state? It was launched by Goa. Then Uttar Pradesh. First e-office system was launched where? It was launched in Kannauj. And recently in UP only, MotoGP was held for the first time in India. Next, India created history by achieving 75% ODF plus free villages under Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. I repeat, India has recently achieved a major milestone under your Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen Phase 2, with 75% villages achieving the ODF, that is Open Defecation Free Plus status. A total of 4.43 lakh villages have been declared themselves ODF Plus, which is a significant step towards achieving Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen Phase 2 goals by 2024-25. If we talk about some states and union territories such as your Andaman and Nicobar Islands, Dadra, Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, then Jammu and Kashmir and Sikkim, correct? They have been 100% ODF Plus free model villages. Correct, and it is expected that whole of India will be coming under this mission by 2024-25. If we talk about Swachh Bharat Mission, this Swachh Bharat Mission was launched in 2014. It was released by Ministry of Jal Shakti, and the main aim was to achieve universal sanitization coverage and to put focus on sanitation. Next is India-Iran Joint Chamber of Commerce. They have signed a memorandum of understanding with which organization to boost trade and investment. So India-Iran Joint Chamber of Commerce, they signed a memorandum of understanding with FIEO, that is Federation of Indian Export Organization, and it was to develop cooperation in the field of trade, investment, quality standards and technology transfer. So it was India-Iran Joint Chamber of Commerce along with FIEO. If we talk about Iran, what is the capital here? Tehran. Then currency, Iranian rial. And who is the president here? Ebrahim Raisi. Right? Then apart from this, friends, if we discuss global or we can say global traditional medicines global summit or traditional medicine global summit was recently held where? It was held in Gandhinagar, Gujarat, and it was held with the help of WHO. Right? Then apart from this, where is India's first 3D printed post office being built? It is being built in Bangalore, and it is expected that the cost of this construction will be less than by 30-40%. Then apart from this, which state government will be organizing Pro Govinda League on Janmashtami? It was organized by Maharashtra. Then apart from this, which airport became the first airport in Northeast to get Digi Yatra facility? First airport in Northeast India to get the Digi Yatra facility, that is Guwahati Airport. That is Guwahati Airport. Next, which Indian naval ship participated in first India, Indonesia and Australia trilateral maritime exercise? So which is this Indian naval ship that took part in this first India, Indonesia, Australia trilateral maritime exercise? It is INS Shadri, right? This exercise was held from 21st to 22nd of September. And in this, Indian Navy, Royal Australian Navy and your Indonesian Navy took part, and from here Indian naval ship Shadri took part in this mission, and it was deployed in the Indo-Pacific region to carry out this exercise. Then this INS Shadri was captained by whom? The captain of this INS is Ranjan Kapoor, and remember, this is the third ship of the indigenously designed and built Project 17, right? So it is INS Shadri that took part here in this exercise. Next, name the person who launched Bharat NCAP, that is Bharat New Car Assessment Program. It was launched by Nitin Gadkari, and he also unveiled a new flex fuel vehicle, that is your Innova, built by Innova and the built by Toyota, and the car is Innova and the model is Hycross. Correct. Then apart from this, a new variety of lotus was discovered recently, or a new variety of lotus was basically, you can say, it was mutated by scientists in lab and it was framed in lab. This lotus contains 108 petals, And then that is the reason this was named as NAMO 108. Next, banking and finance. Recently, SIDBI signed a pact with DLAI to boost the fintech sector. I repeat, an MOU has been inked between SIDBI and Digital Lenders Association of India to boost the India's fintech sector by utilizing each other's expertise. This MOU was signed during the UN Conclave 2023 event that was organized by DLAI in Goa. I repeat, recently it is SIDBI. They have signed a pact with DLAI, that is your Digital Lenders Association of India, and it is to boost India's fintech sector by utilizing each other's expertise. This MOU was signed during an Unconclave 2023 event organized by DLAI in Goa. Correct. Then the MOU will focus on creating standard protocols for digital lending practices, right? This will include your SIDBI. Here will offer resource support to eligible DLAI's member NBFCs. The agreement will also explore partnership with various direct credit schemes such as your Prayas, GST Sahay, Express Loan and Green Financing. Right? Next. Next is SEBI board has approved the various proposals and has discussed the tech trends in the security market. I repeat, SEBI has discussed various trends in the security markets and on SEBI approach to proactively plan for the same during the 202nd board meeting held in September 21 in Mumbai, Maharashtra. SEBI has also approved following proposals. First is flexibility in the framework of large corporate for meeting incremental financing needs through the issuance of debt securities. Second, SEBI extended the timeline for compliance with enhanced qualification and experience requirements for the investment advisors. And third, streamlining the framework for credit of unclaimed amount of investors in listed entities other than companies, REITs, InvITs to IPEF. Right? Next. Next is FinMin, that is your finance ministry, has retained India's GDP growth estimate for fiscal year 24 to be around 6.5%, right? The risk to the growth outlook were offset by the bright spots in the corporate profitability, private sector capital formation, bank credit growth and activity in the construction sector. So coming back, recently the Department of Economic Affairs that comes under the Ministry of Finance has retained the India's GDP growth estimate for fiscal year 24 to be 6.5%. Next is which village of India has been selected as the best tourism village of India 2023. So it is Bishwanath Ghat. This village is in Assam and it has been declared as the best tourism village of India 2023. All right, this Bishwanath Ghat is also known by the term Gupta Kashi, right? And remember here, Ministry of Tourism has also selected Kriteshwari village in West Bengal as the best tourism village of India. That is Kriteshwari village. And where is this? This is in West Bengal. Correct. The villages were selected from among 791 applications from 31 states and union territories. Then coming back, remember, if we talk about Modhera, it is the first city to be developed as 100% solar, or first village to be developed as 100% solar village, or 100% solar, first 100% solar village of India is Modhera in Gujarat, and first 100% solar city of India is Sanchi, that is in Madhya Pradesh. Next, here you can see Bishwanath Ghat in Assam selected as the best tourism village of India 2023. Who is the Chief Minister of Assam? Himanta Biswa Sarma, right? And he declared that Bishwanath Ghat, also known as Gupta Kashi of Assam, as the best tourism village of India 2023. Next is appointments and a resignation. Recently, Asian Development Bank has appointed Bhargav Das Gupta, as you can see him in the picture, as the Vice President for a period of 3 years. So who has been appointed as the Vice President of Asian Development Bank? He will be, as you can see in the picture, Bhargav Das Gupta. Correct. And he is the Vice President of Market Solutions. Prior to this appointment, he was serving as the Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of ICICI Lombard General Insurance since 2009. Right? Take a note of this. Next, we talk about Asian Development Bank. Who is the president here? Masasugu Asakawa. Headquarter is in Manila, Philippines, and it was established in 1966. Moving on, Tata Electronics chairman Banamali Agarwal has been appointed as the new chairman of Tata Advanced Systems. I repeat, Banamali Agarwala has been appointed as the new chairman of Tata Advanced Systems Limited, the Aerospace and Defense Solution Division and wholly owned subsidiary of Tata Sons and the holding company of the Tata Group. Prior to this appointment, he was serving as the senior advisor of Tata Sons and chairman of Tata Electronics Private Limited. He will succeed whom? He will be succeeding Vijay Singh. Right? Next is science and tech. Recently, archaeologists found the world's oldest wood structure in Zambia dating back to 476,000 years ago. I repeat, archaeologist has found the world's oldest wooden structure in Zambia that date backs to almost 476,000 years ago. Right? And where was this found? It was found in the Colombo River in Zambia. The findings of this structure were published in journal Nature on 20th of September 2023. Important, take a note of it. Right? The remains of this ancient complex wood structure predate Homo sapiens humans by over 1 lakh years, suggesting that early Homo hominins were experts at woodworking, because we can see clearly that this is an X. Next is Israel has unveiled MBT, fifth generation lightning version of Merkava tank. I repeat, recently Israel has unveiled MBT, fifth generation lightning version of Merkava tank. Right, it is your Merkava Mark 5, also known as Berek, which translates to lightning in Hebrew. And this Merkava 5 is the refined version of the Merkava 4. Correct. And the question can be asked that this Merkava Mark 5 tank is of which country? It is of Israel. It is of Israel. The tank underwent 5 years of development. And the Berek tank was developed jointly by the Defense Ministry's Armored Vehicle Directorate and the IDF's Ground Force and Armored Corps. The first model of the tank were delivered to the 52nd Armored Battalion of the 401st Brigade. Coming back, and in simple words, Merkava Mark 5 tank, also known as Berek, is of Israel. Next is related to environment. Recently, Zoological Survey of India discovered new species of deep water marine fish off the West Bengal coast. As you can see the fish, this is the new species and it is Pterygotrigla intermedica. I repeat, Zoological Survey of India, they have identified a new species of vibrant orange deep water marine fish that was named Pterygotrigla intermedica, right? And it is from West Bengal. Directly remember this. Coming back, if we talk about Zoological Survey of India, who is the director here? Dr. Dhirti Banerjee. Headquarter is in Kolkata, West Bengal, and it was established in 1916. Then next comes your sports. We just discovered that in UP, we saw MotoGP to be held for the first time in India, right? And who won this inaugural session of the MotoGP Grand Prix India 2023? It was won by Marco Beccacci, right? And here you can see UP's chief minister who was awarding the trophy to him, right? And he is Yogi Adityanath. So Italy's Marco Beccacci of Moni VR46 racing team has won the Indian Oil Grand Prix of India that was held at the Buddha International Circuit, Greater Noida, UP, right? Here you can see who topped it or who won this, Marco Beccacci. Right, then on second position, George Martin and Fabio Quartararo on third position. So these are the first, second and third position in MotoGP. Then Indian Grand Prix was the 13th out of 20 races in the MotoGP session for 2023. Next is obituary. Former Italian president Giorgio Napolitano has recently passed away. I repeat, Giorgi Napolitano, former president of Italy in 2006 and 2015 and a leader of Italian Communist Party, recently passed away at the age of 98 in Rome, Italy. He was the longest serving and the longest lived president in the history of modern Italian Republic. Next is your World Reverse Day. When do we observe this? On 24th of September. We observe this World Reverse Day in the year 2023. Otherwise, remember, World Reverse Day is annually observed on the 4th Sunday of September, and in 2023, it was 24th of September, right? So take a note of it. Next comes your World Pharmacist Day. On 25th of September, we observe World Pharmacist Day, and it is to encourage activities that promote and advocate the role of pharmacists in every corner of the world. That day also marks the foundation day of the International Pharmaceutical Federation, a global body for pharmacy, pharmaceutical sciences, and pharmaceutical education. So, World Pharmacist Day is observed on 25th of September. Next, when do we observe Antyodaya Divas? Antyodaya Divas is observed to commemorate the birth anniversary of Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay, who was the former leader of the political party BJS, that is Bharatiya Jana Sangh. Right, and in the year 2023, it was 107th birth anniversary of Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay. So this day is observed every year on 25th of September. Right, and the main aim of this Antyodaya Divas is basically to uplift the poor in the society. So here you can see Antyodaya Divas observed on 25th of September, and it is observed on the birth anniversary of Pandit Deendayal Upadhyay, as you can see him in the picture. So friends, these were your important current affairs. Now let's go for a one-liner revision. India's first lighthouse festival held in Goa to promote lighthouses as tourist destinations. India creates history, achieved 75% ODF plus villages under Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. Iran-India Joint Chamber of Commerce and FIEO, they signed an MOU to boost trade and investment. Then INS Shahadri participated in the first India-Indonesia-Australia Trilateral Maritime Exercise. SIDBI has signed a pact with DLAI to boost the fintech sector. SEBI board approved various proposals and discusses tech trends in security markets. Fin Finance Ministry has retained 6.5% GDP growth rate estimate for fiscal year 24. Biswanath Ghat in Assam has selected as the best tourism village of 2023. Asian Development Bank appointed Bhargav Das Gupta as the Vice President for Market Solutions. Next is Tata Electronics Chairman Banamali Agarwala has been appointed as the new Chairman of Tata Advanced Systems. Archaeologists found world's oldest wood structure in Zambia dating back to 476,000 years ago. Then Israel, they have unveiled the MBT 5th generation lightning version of the Merkava tank. Petri Gotrigla Intermedica, this is a new species of the deep water marine fish that were discovered off the coast of West Bengal by ZSI. Then Marco Bagacci has won the inaugural MotoGP Grand Prix of India 2023. Former Italian President Giorgi Napolitano has recently passed away. World Reverse Day on 24th September, World Pharmacist Day on 25th September, and Antyodaya Divas on 25th of September. So these are your important day friends, important current affairs for today. Now let's shift to revision part. Amazon Web Service AWS, they have tied up with ISRO to advance the AI capabilities. IndiGo became the official airline for the Indian football team. Gujarat passed a bill reserving 27% reservation in the local body seats for the OBCs. Rajnath Singh approved 23 new Sainik schools in partnership mode. Government of India has received 1,487 crore rupees from NTPC as dividend tranche. Tata Steel signed £500 million deal with UK government. Ashok Leyland signed an MOU with UP government to set up integrated e-bus plant. Dharmendra Pradhan, Om Birla, they have launched Skill on Wheels. Mark this important. Next, Delhi Metro Rail Corporation signed with Bharat Electronics Limited to develop communication-based training control system. Then IIT Kanpur partnered with ICICI Bank to foster startup innovation. नेक्स्ट प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना जो कि एक नेशनल मिशन फॉर फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन है, इन्होंने कंप्लीट कर लिया है कितने 9 ईयर्स ऑफ सक्सेसफुल इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑन 28th of August. आई रिपीट, प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना जो कि एक नेशनल मिशन फॉर फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन है, इसने 9 साल पूरे कर लिए हैं सक्सेसफुल इंप्लीमेंटेशन के. प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना ये इनिशिएटिव था, लॉन्च किया गया था पीएम नरेंद्र मोदी के द्वारा, कब, ऑन 15th of August in 2014. करेक्ट. एंड इसका एम क्या है कि हर आदमी को फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज, बेसिक सेविंग अकाउंट, डिपॉजिट अकाउंट, क्रेडिट, इंश्योरेंस, ये सारी चीज़ें प्रोवाइड कराने की बात की गई. नेक्स्ट, पीएम मोदी ने एड्रेस किया बिजनेस 20 समिट इंडिया को हेल्ड इन न्यू दिल्ली. व्हाट इज द थीम ऑफ दिस B20 2023? तो B20 की जो थीम थी वो थी रेस. रेस क्या है? रिस्पॉन्सिबल, एक्सेलरेटेड, इनोवेटिव, सस्टेनेबल, इक्विटेबल बिजनेस. करेक्ट, तो ऑप्शन 4 यहाँ ठीक रहेगा. पीएम मोदी ने एड्रेस किया B20 समिट इंडिया 2023 को जो न्यू दिल्ली में हुई, जिसकी थीम थी रेस. ये याद रखेंगे, इंपॉर्टेंट रहेगा. ठीक है, चलिए नेक्स्ट पे आते हैं. नेक्स्ट है नितिन गडकरी जी के द्वारा अभी रिसेंटली वर्ल्ड की पहली प्रोटोटाइप ऑफ BS6 Stage 2 कंप्लायंट इलेक्ट्रीफाइड फ्लेक्स फ्यूल व्हीकल को लॉन्च किया गया. ये आपकी इनोवा गाड़ी रहेगी, इनोवा हाई क्रॉस. इनोवा किस कंपनी की है? टोयोटा के द्वारा बनाई गई है. करेक्ट, तो क्वेश्चन पूछा जा रहा है कि विच कंपनी डेवलप दिस इलेक्ट्रीफाइड फ्लेक्स फ्यूल व्हीकल. तो टोयोटा किर्लोस्कर मोटर प्राइवेट लिमिटेड के द्वारा ये इनोवा हाई क्रॉस बनाई गई, जो कि वर्ल्ड की पहली प्रोटोटाइप रहेगी ऑफ भारत Stage 6 Stage 2 कंप्लायंट इलेक्ट्रीफाइड फ्लेक्स फ्यूल व्हीकल. ठीक है, ऑल्सो ये आपकी 100% इलेक्ट्रिक मोड पे रन कर सकती है. ऑल्सो दिस इज इन लाइन विद इंडियाज टारगेट टू इंक्रीज द एथेनॉल ब्लेंडिंग इन पेट्रोल बाय 20% बाय 2025-26. नेक्स्ट, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया द्रौपदी मुर्मू ने रिलीज किया कमेमोरेटिव 100 रुपीज का सिल्वर कॉइन फीचरिंग द इमेज ऑफ डैश, जो कि फॉर्मर चीफ मिनिस्टर हैं आंध्र प्रदेश के. तो किनके कमेमोरेटिव कॉइन, किनकी बर्थ एनिवर्सरी पर यहाँ पे लॉन्च किया गया, जो कि 100th birth anniversary थी? तो वो है नंदामुरी तराका रामा राव. इनकी बर्थ एनिवर्सरी पर यहाँ पर एक 100 रुपीज़ का सिल्वर कॉइन लॉन्च किया गया दैट फीचर्स द इमेज ऑफ हिम, जो कि फॉर्मर चीफ मिनिस्टर थे आंध्र प्रदेश के और एक काफ़ी फेमस लेजेंडरी इंडियन एक्टर भी रह चुके हैं. अगर हम इस कॉइन की बात करें तो ये जो आपका कॉइन है 44 mm डायमीटर में रहेगा. 50% यहाँ पे सिल्वर है, 40% यहाँ पर आपका कॉपर रहेगा एंड 5% यहाँ पे आपका निकल रहेगा. करेक्ट, एंड 5% ही आपका जिंक रहेगा. नेक्स्ट, नेम द कंपनी जिन्होंने साइन किया एक MOU कीनिया शिपयार्ड्स लिमिटेड के साथ फॉर द कोलैबोरेशन ऑफ शिप डिजाइन एंड बिल्डिंग. तो वो कौन है? वो है आपका गोवा शिपयार्ड्स लिमिटेड. राइट, गोवा शिपयार्ड लिमिटेड ने कीनिया शिपयार्ड लिमिटेड के साथ एक MOU साइन किया ताकि शिप डिजाइन एंड शिप बिल्डिंग में आगे कोलैबोरेशन किया जा सके एंड आगे एक दूसरे के साथ नॉलेज शेयर करके नई नई टेक्नोलॉजी से आपके यहाँ पर बिल्ड किया जा सके. फिर कीनिया से ही अगर आपको याद रखना पड़ेगा यहाँ पर कि कीनिया में अभी CT स्कैन टेक्नोलॉजी प्रोवाइड कराने की बात की गई इंडिया के द्वारा. राइट, ताकि वहाँ पर कीनिया में CT स्कैन की फैसिलिटी प्रोवाइड हो सके. एंड यहीं पर 15 pairs ऑफ पैराशूट्स प्रोवाइड कराए गए बाय इंडिया के डिफेंस मिनिस्टर राजनाथ सिंह ने एज अ गिफ्ट टू द केनिया फोर्सेस. नेक्स्ट इज एयर इंडिया, दे हैव स्टार्टेड प्रोजेक्ट अभिनंदन एट 16 एयरपोर्ट्स. रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर शांति निकेतन गेट्स द यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज टैग. वीमेन्स रिजर्वेशन बिल वॉज पास इन लोकसभा. PM मोदी लेड द फाउंडेशन स्टोन फॉर लॉर्ड शिवा थीम स्टेडियम इन उत्तर प्रदेश. होयसाला टेम्पल्स नाउ इंडियाज 42nd यूनेस्कोज वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट. इंपॉर्टेंट, गवर्नमेंट लॉन्च 3 इनिशिएटिव्स फॉर फार्मर्स. प्रेजिडेंट मुर्मू इनाग्रेटेड द फर्स्ट UP इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड शो. PM मोदी इनाग्रेटेड 16 अटल आवासीय विद्यालय इन उत्तर प्रदेश. कैबिनेट अप्रूव द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ उज्ज्वला योजना. अनुराग ठाकुर इनाग्रेटेड सिंथेटिक एथलेटिक ट्रैक्स. Then next is related to banking. SIDBI has partnered with Tata Power for MSME solar rooftoping financing. Yes Bank partnered with BriskPay to enable seamless cross-border payments. Odisha government signed an MOU with 6 public sector banks to provide banking. Max Life Insurance entered a health wellness segment with new plan Seva. Indian Bank rolled out IB Sathi to provide basic banking services. Yes Bank partnered with JustPay to offer merchant in-app UPI payments. Then IREDA partnered with Bank of Maharashtra to promote renewable energy adoption. SBI introduced digital opening of NRE/NRO account set up through YONO, and YONO is the mobile application of SBI. ECHO introduced the Platinum Health Plan. Ujjivan Small Finance Bank has introduced Maxima Saving Account. So friend, these were your revision part. Now let's move to homework section. First, which institution is set to launch the online platform called Bima Sugam? Next, the 128th Constitution Amendment Bill 2023 was introduced recently is associated with Dash. And third, this is your second, this is your third. Which state's chief minister has been awarded the Lee Kuan Yew Exchange Fellowship? So these are your three homework questions, friends. And I want to see maximum participation of students in the homework questions. And if you find the session interesting, all you have to do is like the video and share as well as subscribe to the channel. So that's all for the day. Thank you and have a nice day.
That's all for the day, friends. I hope you enjoyed the session and you can follow us on the YouTube channel as well as apart from YouTube channel, you can go and follow us at Affairs Cloud Telegram channel. And if you have any queries related to the content or the of courses offered to you or the payment which you did on the application, you can contact us on the number provided, that is 7677333862. Apart from this, friends, you can follow us on the Facebook as well as on Instagram handle, that is affairscloud_official. In the end, friends, if you use a code, that is Vikas10, you will be getting an additional extra 10% discount by using this code Vikas10. Also, if you have any problem regarding the course purchase, any problem regarding to our application, you can contact us on the mobile number, that is 9677333862. And if you want to mail us, you can also mail us on support@affairscloud.com. And I assure you that our representative from us will be contacting you soon and resolving your issue.